Hi to everyone, this is the new Yamaha. It's a monitor, it's a powered, has a built-in amplifier of 22 watts, it's a speaker. It comes in two boxes. It comes actually in one box per speaker. If you like to buy a second one, you just receive a second box. So this is a MSP3A. The funny thing about this is it has a lot of technologies, it's a powered monitor speaker. And it's not expensive, that's a good thing, and has no digital, no wireless, no DSP, so it's a pure original speaker with original sound of Yamaha. The box says it's just 5 kilos, so it's good for us, but it's not a big thing or big device to unbox and to present. It's a straightforward, but This baby has technologies of the big, very expensive speakers of Yamaha. You see the cable here is very well treated, very well, an expensive cable for the power. So this is a thing that indicates that the beauty inside is in high quality. Here is the speaker. Oh, it's heavy, isn't it? This is the speaker. Small but very efficient. And this is the manual here with all the specs. Let's have a look inside. So this is the owner manual, has the measurement here, frequency response, block diagram. So Yamaha is very careful with all this. We have a tone control for low and high. Here are the specs, 65 hertz to up to 22 kilohertz. The frequency, crossover frequency is 4 kHz, and then we have the drivers. We have a tweeter of 0.8 inches and one woofer of 4 inches, dom and con. So this is very well designed, and it's a good solution for a lot of us, because we can use it to our TV, you can use it to our computer, you can use it to our home studio we have. We can use this for surround speakers or a ceiling speaker if we have an Atmos system and we like to just to go low level signal there, since these ones are powered. 200 euros it's safe. You see underneath there are these holes to install the brackets or the stand. This is the back of the speaker. We have this port here, input we have a line. The adjustments are in the front. We have the level one, line one, line two for the two inputs to adjust the level. And then we have the high and the low to bring the sound of the speaker according to our preferences. We see the tweeter there. There is a micro horn loaded, and the woofer here, it's protected by a metallic grill. So after removing a few screws, we discover the inner world of this speaker. We can see the flare, the twisted flare port here. This technology comes from the big 5000 speakers of Yamaha, which are very expensive. No digital, as we said, no wireless, no Bluetooth, just pure audio, analog signal. The power supply is linear. It's linear. We see the transformer here. The transistor there is the world famous LM. Rubicon capacitors with special glue at the bottom to minimize the vibrations. So it's a beauty inside, simplicity at everywhere. We see the crossover there that crosses at 4 kilohertz, the electrolytic capacitor and the coil that has a of iron core there. We see the woofer from Yamaha, 4 hertz, and those cables there are for the level and for the adjustment of high and low. The cables are very well treated with this special foam around. You see the heatsink of the LM, an amplifier, a power supply, Rubicon capacitors of 6,800 microfarads. The cabinet, okay, it's hard plastic. This is the whole thing. It costs less than 200 euros. So you get two, you have a stereo, like an audiophile without any compromises or any add-on features that destroy the sound, let's say. The front, you see the logo, there is an LED light there. Adjustments, the grill, and the tweeter, which is a fiber dome. Maybe looks like a metallic dome, but it's not. So this is the monitor powered speaker, which is very nice designed. The back, as we said, accepts RCA here line, XLR, and in the center accepts 6.3 millimeters jack. The port, so guys, that was the presentation of this speaker. Sounds amazing. Thanks for watching.